Good morning. Today's options lesson is on assignment on short put options. I'm going to use the on-demand feature of Thinkorswim so I can go back in time and show you exactly what I was looking at on October 12, 2018. Today's actual date is October 9, 2019. This is a hypothetical trade because I just wanted to show you how to handle short put options that go in the money at expiration. Let's start out by looking at the 1 year daily chart of Facebook. And this date right here is October 12, 2018. And if you come down to the slow stochastics, it's down at the bottom in the oversold region. And it is also a double bottom on the chart. So one could assume that this is the support line and that Facebook might go back up in the next 30 days. So one could place a semi-bullish trade on Facebook. There are many ways to do a bullish trade. The one I'm going to show you in this video is selling to open put options. When you're selling put options, you're basically betting that the stock is going to go back up and stay above your strike price. Now let's jump over to the trading tab. And let's suppose that we're going to sell this put option with 35 days until expiration. Strike price is 140, and this is about $12 out of the money. So it is $12 below the current price of the stock, which is 152. So one could assume that this is a relatively safe trade, and we're going to collect $3.20 upfront per contract. This translates into $320. You will get to keep 100% of this only if you hold the trade all the way until expiration, November 16th, and if Facebook closes above 140. So let's go ahead and place this hypothetical trade. I'm selling one contract. This is a negative one, so I'm going to be short one put option. And it's trading between 320 and 325, so we're going to aim for something in this region. The trade filled at $3.25. That means I collected $325 up front. That's the trade price. And this is all extrinsic or time value because this put option is currently out of the money. That means the strike price is below the current price of the stock, which is 152. When you're selling put options, you should always, always sell put options that are out of the money. That means the strike price is below the current price of the stock. Let's suppose that you placed a trade on October 12, 2018, and then you went on a long vacation for a month, and you never looked at your trade, and then you came back on November 16, which was the expiration date. And you open up your account, and you see that your put option is now in the money with about 10 minutes left until expiration. So we have jumped over to November 16. And again, I am using on demand so I can show you exactly what the data looked like on November 16. So this is now expiration Friday. The clock's ticking. It's 12:49 p.m. Pacific time. There are 10 minutes left until expiration. The stock is trading at 139.73-ish, It is just slightly below my strike price of 140. So it is in the money, and specifically, it is in the money by about 28, 29 cents. If you look under PL Open, you will see that there is a profit. Why is there a profit when the option is in the money? Well, the reason is because when you sold the option on October 12th, you received $3.25. And now, on expiration Friday, you can buy that option back for 31 cents. So the difference between your original credit and the current price of the option is your profit. So at this point, you have several choices. You can keep holding the option for another 10 minutes and see what happens, but you should only do that if you really want to take the assignment, meaning that you really want to own 100 shares of the stock. In this case, it's Facebook. If you're ambivalent about holding the stock, then closing it out would be the recommended action. So remember, even though this option is currently in the money by 50 cents, we still have a profit on the trade because it is only in the money by 50 cents. There's very, very little time value remaining. In fact, it's almost zero, but it is in the money by about 51, 52 cents. And that is the remaining intrinsic value of the option. So the right thing to do at this point is simply to buy back your option, take your profits, and remove the risk of assignment. This is very close, but the goal of trading options is to make money. So in this case, we do have a profit of about $267. Under BP effect, it shows a negative $5,600. That means this trade is using up $5,638 of buying power. Once I close a trade, I can free up this capital and move on to the next trade. This is obviously using margin. In a non-margin account, the BP effect would be a much larger number. Specifically, I would need to have enough cash to cover the purchase or the assignment of 100 shares of Facebook at $140 per share. That would be $14,000. So now with about 6 minutes remaining until expiration, I am going to buy back this option and remove the risk. So to close out a short put position, just highlight a position, select create closing order, and simply buy back the option. My closing trade filled at 43 cents. So the total profit is the original credit of 325 minus the cost to buy back the short put of 43 cents. That equals 2.82 times one contract times 100 is $282. So in this example, even though my short put option ended up in the money at expiration, this trade was still profitable simply because it was slightly out of the money and I was able to buy it back at a price less than the original credit. Fast forward to 1 p.m. Pacific time, expiration Friday, November 16. Facebook closed at 139.53, so it actually did close in the money at the end. So if I had not bought back my short put option, I would have been assigned 100 shares of Facebook at $140 per share. So in this example, I showed you one way to close out a trade with a profit, even though the option was in the money. When I'm selling put options, my goal is to make a profit on the trade and not necessarily get assigned on the stock. In rare cases, I'm okay with taking the assignment, but in about 99.9% of the time, I am not interested in getting assigned on the short put, meaning that I am not interested in buying 100 shares of the underlying stock. I prefer to just keep my capital free and not tie up my money by owning stock. Thank you for watching, and remember to share the knowledge and spread the wealth.